regulation business without structured, empowered motivational effects with Mirabia Elias. Today I want to focus on the terminology business itself, right? The terminology office itself, the requirement for the business to function in a set protocol and the set process that is functional for the office requirement. And when we focus on the terminology business today, I want us to listen to the office that rightly acknowledge to adhere to the responsibility that are building office, right? That meaning the responsibility that are the restructured business itself. The restructured business becomes the responsibility of the office to acknowledge and to adhere to every requirement that the office has with building business and with managing the office required processes on Hyundai, right? And that then becomes the business that does not only function under responsibility only, but the business that are rightfully owned. The business that recognized its required ownership, right? The business that recognized its required function when it was managing processes amongst the different businesses in the international world. And therefore, the business that on today's terminology of business offers does not corrupt the process and the function of business in the international world itself. Therefore, the rightly acknowledge means the non-corruption that the business then adheres to. They are required to adhere to the responsibility, and we know the right from wrong application and responsibility that we have as business owners. And we know that we live in a world where corruption has become the number one process that everyone finds themselves busy with in business and in functioning on a daily basis. We learn that corruption has caused our generation to be in so much poverty, to be in so much aggression, to be in so much finding themselves in so much wars, that we have the requirement that I, Rabia Elias, find myself educating the structured responsibility that business owners has, the structured responsibility that the law has today, that has us function in a way that are fair and fine for every country's requirement and every country's responsibility. And therefore, with our motivation today and with our empowered fit that we're gonna educate through this podcast, we want the listeners to acknowledge themselves in the room of business today. We want the listeners to acknowledge their household in the room of business today, where their household functions from when they find themselves being employed as an employee in business, being the owner of a business today, being a representative of a business, being a business partner in the world, and being that that becomes the responsibility and the responsible one that are required to adhere to process business. And we actually educating it on every part of my social media pages so that we get the listeners to understand to where do I educate from in my season, not where do I educate from in my career history, but in my experience in this season that I have become familiar with the challenges that our generation has that requires us to acknowledge ourselves in the room, that requires me, Rabia Elias, to acknowledge myself when I educate HR 2024 business restructuring with Rabia Elias in the room, right? With my opinion, with my acknowledgement, with my recognition to self, right? And with acknowledging the function business itself, with acknowledging the requirement that offices has to structure themselves in business, with acknowledging the law that stands in line with my education in season, that we require in season, that the house of the international law finds themselves listening to Rabia Elias's explanation in education and the restructure requirement for businesses to adhere to the function business. Why? Because law finds themselves hand in hand in the business world with adhering to the requirement and responsibility that humanity has with where they are at, with financially being fair and fine, and with financially being provided for, and with acknowledging and recognizing the office business and the legislative responsibility of the law house today. And therefore, we direct directly speak to the law firm. We do not want to exclude and call in person to listen to our podcast and our motivations, but we require everyone that finds themselves in office, managing office, and employee in office to listen to our educations, where we are at in our season, and to therefore implement the required responsibility that they have to implement, the acknowledgement of the building office in our generation and in our season and time. And therefore, with acknowledging that we have a requirement to adhere to that, that we own the responsibility that is every structured process in my business, I find myself responsible enough to manage it in a way that are fair and fine. And we do not say that in business in the world, corruption is not acceptable. We say that for people that have corruption, that are a required process among certain businesses and among certain processes in a world that had to be funded for, and every household that has to be funded for, we require the part of business that functions under that they put themselves under the terminology of corruption, that they therefore adhere to their responsibility to acknowledge the process and structured requirement of business in that explanation and in that requirement that we have as human beings, that we know we all have a requirement, and we know we are so much dysfunction, and we know we cannot exclude people who are now corrupt in their daily lives, but we require the corrupt person to understand the requirement to be responsible with where we are at with building office in the international world. And therefore, the corruption should not be in a way that are oppressive to countries, in a way that are stirring wars and aggressions, in a way that are oppressive to where the earth and where humanity already finds themselves in so much poverty and so much abuses, but our corruption should be in a way that are sometimes rightly acknowledging our responsibilities, right? The right from wrong, meaning the rightly acknowledging our responsibility with building office in the international world. And therefore, when we find ourselves in different lifestyle choices, and the lifestyle choice requires the corrupt person to own a business in their way, they acknowledge themselves in the process, they acknowledge the requirement that they have to abide to process and function business in the world, and they acknowledge the people that they make business with in the international world. How countries can be affected by corruption, and where we find corruption, and they call it, I know Jacinda Dandem spoke about a red light, a green light, a yellow light process when we had COVID-19, and corruption finds themselves under the yellow light of the red light, green light, yellow light process of where humanity functions from, that we are the human beings. We are now not the car driving on the road, but our responsibility are to adhere to the function business and to how we are building office and business in the international world. And therefore, our business processes should not be disruptive to humanity in a way that are causing wars and causing aggressions and causing oppressions to countries. And our business responsibility should be a functional responsibility that we rightfully own our right to manage our businesses in a way that are fair and fine, right? Rightly, we acknowledge not to corrupt the business and the function business in the international office of the international world. That's what we want to focus on with this empowered fit, everyone. We don't want everyone too distracted. We don't want everyone to all over the place with our podcast. And we had problems with logging into podcast, so I'm sharing this on my Facebook podcast education. And then we will try and upload it onto Castbox when our app is ready. But for now, let us listen to our explanation and requirement to acknowledge our responsibility when we are building office in the world. Our responsibility that we rightly own our requirement to manage our businesses in a way that are non-dysfunctional to the world and to the international world. And for every person that starts a business fresh in these years, we've highly advised not to begin dysfunctional and oppressive businesses that are going to be dysfunctional to the international world, that are trying to structure already so much processes, right? We have already so much requirement that we have to be acknowledging ourselves with, when we look at the international world and the dysfunctioning of certain businesses and offices, that we have the requirement to request of every business owner to not find themselves disrupting the international world with disruptive and corruptive businesses that are going to be oppressive to humanity. And therefore, another part of discussing on the business requirement and the requirement business today, we want to also quickly discuss the law house of the international world, where we share every empowered fact through on our Instagram pages. I'm now sharing it on my LinkedIn pages for the office of the world to listen and to follow in on the educations and to educate in their business processes and in team meetings on what's required and on what I explain through my Evoke and through my Leading This Generation educations. And I therefore want everyone's attention to our requirement for the legislative house of the international world to adhere to their responsibility when they deal with corruption that relates to wars and with business owners that are investing in businesses that find themselves corrupt. The percentage that business owners are allowed to invest in own business that find themselves involved in corruption, right? And the acknowledgement of where corruption has led our international world to, and the wars, countries that find themselves in war accounted for, the amount of countries that find themselves in war should be accounted for when the international law implements my required requests that I've sent through to them via my Instagram post, right? I've sent a lot of requests and I have acknowledged specifically the international law house that listens into my podcast and their requirement to therefore be therefore managing the function business under the legislative responsibility of business owners to therefore decide to make business with in and to invest in business owners that are non-corruptive and not to find themselves investing in business owners that are stirring wars and that are stirring corruptions and that are oppressive and abusive to humanity itself, right? So therefore, accounting how many countries we have on this earth that finds themselves in war, accounting the wars related to what business functions, accounting how much investment of those war countries went to small business owners and most recent business owners in 1 year time frame, and therefore trying to legislatively adhere and manage our structured responsibility with building office in the international world. And that is where we are at with this podcast, everyone. I know I can say a lot sometimes, but don't be disrupted by all that I'm saying. That's listen to everything that I say and have every education and implementation plan in a structured, required way that are fine and fair for the international people of the world. Have an amazing people of color leading this generation season with our structured educations.